Morning, it's Helen, and this one is going to be a salutation class. So sun and moon salutation. So it's going to be a really good flowing class. As ever, I will give you options, and so take them as you need. Do listen to your body. If I'm saying something and it doesn't feel right for you, then ignore me and listen to your body. But enjoy. What's that volume? So coming onto your mat, we're going to start kneeling if that's comfortable for you. If not, remain standing. Or sit cross-legged, whatever you want to do. So if you're happy to close those eyes up, then do so. And just start bringing your awareness to your breath. So steady in-breath through your nose, directing it down to the belly, to the ribcage, so it's expanding in every direction. And as you breathe out, back through the nose, just let it all nestle back down. So try and keep your focus on tracing your breath in and out. When your mind wanders, which I'm sure it will, just accept that without judgment and bring it back to focusing on the task. When those thoughts pop into your head, see if you can just let them go, or see whether you just need to park them to bring back to thinking about later. So starting linking breath with movement. Going to inhale, shrug shoulders up to ears, and exhale low. And again, inhale, shrug it up. Exhale low. One more. Inhale high. Exhale low. This time we're going to sweep hands wide. Inhale, lengthen up. Little back bend if you want. Exhale, sweep hands back down. Two more. Inhale, lift. Open that heart. Exhale low. One more, inhale. And exhale lower. This time we're gonna ground through one hand just to the side behind your bum, lifting up and open with the other arm. Press those ribs out to the side. Exhale lower back down at the side. Inhale up. Exhale low. We'll go again, inhale up. And exhale down. Last one. Inhale up. And exhale down. Gonna come forward into child's pose. So keeping knees narrow or send the knees wide. You can lower head to the floor or you can stay lifted depending what feels more comfortable for you. Feel free to have a wriggle, nestle down. And again, bring your awareness back to the breath. Let the belly chill here. As you take that breath in, direct it down to the belly ribcage. Feel that movement. How far down can you feel that movement? Can you feel it down into your pelvis? Back up onto all fours. Walk both hands just forward of the shoulders, knees nice and wide. I'm coming to our cat cow. So fingertips spread, press the floor away. We're going to inhale, drop the belly, look forward for your cow. And breathe it out, tuck in tailbone under, push between the hands, look between the knees for your cat. And again, inhale on curl. And exhale, tuck it back under. Inhale back into centre. So with tabletop here, so flat back ideally. We're just going to wake up through the shoulder blades. So here we want you to really press the floor away to arch up through the shoulder blades. And then keeping the elbows where they are, you're just going to think about sending your collarbone down so you get the movement in shoulder blades. So press the floor away, feel the widening of those shoulder blades. Keeping the elbows where they are, send your collarbone down. So hopefully you can feel that movement through the shoulder blades. If you're quite stiff through the shoulders, you might not feel much. But it's something to work on. So a few more. Press the floor, sink that collarbone down. Keep breathing. And then press it back, child's pose. Taking both hands into one direction. Few breaths here. And the other side. Feel that lovely stretch down the side of the body. Coming back into centre. Feeling your child's pose. So we're going to do some salutation from kneeling first. So from your child's pose, we're going to inhale, come up into high kneeling, hands lengthen up. Exhale, forward fold to child's pose. Let your hands slide forward as you press forward. We're going to come down into cobra. So forearms down, slide yourself forward. And we're into cobra. Here, press the floor away. And then think, imagine yourself pulling yourself forward on the mat. So you're using your hands, forearms, to imagine that pull forward. Get activity through the shoulders. Length through the back of the neck. And gently think about drawing your ankle bones into one another so you can feel your bottom become a little bit more active. Few breaths. From here, exhale and lower to the floor. Hands come under shoulders. You're going to press back onto hands and knees again. Press it back. And then down to child's pose again. Inhale, high heel. This time we're going to stride one leg forward, so we'll go right side first into low lunge. So you could be pressed really far forward in here, or to make it a little bit more active, think about lengthening tailbone down. Feel that stretch on the back leg, the front of the back leg I should say. And then see if you can come into range a little bit more. Hands can come high. Steady in and out breath. We're going to exhale, ground through the hands. And then take this to a lizard. So taking the hand onto the inside of that front knee and press out. So you're going to roll onto the outside board of that front foot. Steady breath. Coming back into low lunge. Option here to pick up on the back leg. If hamstrings don't like that, ignore me and pop that foot back down. Have a look past your shoulder. Releasing that leg, tucking the toes, hover the back knee. And we're going to stride back onto tabletop. So ground through the hands, stride back into tabletop. Down to child's pose. Inhale, high kneeling. Exhale, stride forward with the left leg. Come into that low lunge. So take that option again, whether you're tucking under and working with control into range, or just taking the lean forward. Have a play between the two. Feel the difference. Inhale, sweep hands high. Come into lizard, grounding through the right hand, left hand comes onto the left knee, press the knee out, roll onto the outside board of that foot. Coming back into low lunge, option to pick off that back foot
and bring heel to button. Oh, I'm really tight this morning. Breathe into any tension. Releasing that foot, picking up the back knee, ground through the hands, and we're going to press back into child's pose, last time. So from here, we're going to come to downward facing dog. So reach those hands a little further forward, tucking those toes, hover the bum, press to get that long line from head to bottom, and then paddle out through the ankles. Oh, and stay tight. Keep going. Have a paddle out. So this is a good lesson for me in meeting my body where it's at today. I am so tight this morning. So I really have to keep my knees soft. Focus on that breath. Then soften both knees. We're going to do a twist here. So think about sending the sit bones to the ceiling. You're going to twist both knees round to the left, sink the bum towards the right, back into centre down dog, and then the other way. Few more here. And then we're going to walk our feet into the front of the mat, keeping the legs as straight for as long as possible. But do soften the knees if your body's telling you it would rather it. And we're going to curl on up through the spine. Come into tree pose. So we're going to take the right leg first. So, angle the knee out first, press the hips to the front of your mat still, and then take your balance position. So whether that's toes down on the floor, onto shin, avoid the knee, coming onto thigh, or you can cross over in the front. So take your option. But really think about pressing the hips forward and lifting up out of the hips, so the hips stay level. And then take your hand option. Whether that's prayer, or lengthened, or out wide, your choice. Find that vision point, that drishti point that helps you keep that balance and focus. And then bring your awareness back to that breath. Lowering down. We're going to go straight to the other side because we're going to add this on to one of our sun salutations at one point. So, set up again. Press those hips forward, lifting up out of the hips, and take your hand option. Connect with that breath. And release down from here. Ground through the feet, Tadasana. Inhale, take hands high. Mini back bend if you want. Exhale, full fold. Inhale, lengthen, look forward. Exhale, step or jump back to your plank. So you've got options from here. Staying in full plank, or if you would rather, come to knees. Carry on that exhale, lowering down to the floor, or you can hover before you press to either a cobra, so the legs stay down, or press through the tops of your feet, press through your hands, and you're into your up dog. Exhale, either through your knees or going straight back to your downward facing dog. Feel free to paddle out. The
inhale, lengthen, look forward. Stride it forward. Lengthen, look forward. Exhale, full fold. Inhale, turn to standing. We'll go again. Inhale, lengthen hands high. Exhale, full fold. Inhale, lengthen, look forward. Exhale, step or jump to that plank and take your option. Carry on that exhale, hover down to the floor or hover it up. Inhale, press to your cobra or up dog. And then roll into downward facing dog. Paddling out. Right leg, we're going to lengthen up towards the ceiling. Keep pressing evenly through your hands. We're going to stride this leg forward in between our hands, coming to the high lunge. So connect in with that breath again. In your high lunge, make sure you're pressing that weight forward. You think about lengthening tailbone down still. From here, we're going to open to warrior two. So full block on that back foot. Front knee heading where the toes are. And nestle the shoulders down away from the ears. Feel free to shorten the lever and bend those arms. Just lengthen the arms isn't so nice. From here, we're going to fold to triangle. So you're going to lengthen through your front leg, hinge through the hip, lift into the top hand. Keep breathing. So we're going to do that two more times. So press back, come back to your warrior two. And press again, triangle. Breathe, stay open on that top shoulder. And again. Steady breath, press again, triangle. Come back to your warrior two. Extended side angle now. So you're going to bring forearms down to your thigh. Press the thigh away though, so you're nice and active through your middle. And lengthen to the top hand. And just see if you can sink down through the hips. And from here, we're going to reverse our warrior. So back hand comes down the back leg. Stay bent into the front knee. And lift up with the front arm. Two more. Come back. Extended side angle. Steady breath. And again, inhale up to your reverse warrior. Exhale down. Last one. Inhale up. And exhale down. We're going to pivot on that back foot, come to a high lunge. Ground through the hands, we'll take our vinyasa. So you sweep this leg back, keeping it off the floor, you can ground to the floor. Exhale, low down. And then inhale to cobra or up dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. We're going on the left side. Left leg, lengthen up. Stride it forward, come to your high lunge. So just take a second to check your setup. So think about lengthening tailbone under. Press your weight forward. And connect with that breath. Opening out warrior two, so full block on that back leg. Press the outside border of the leg. Foot even into the mat. So we're going to take it to that triangle. So exhale, lengthen through the front leg. Keep that top shoulder lifted. Lifting and looking at that top hand. Coming back. Warrior two.
And again. Steady breath. Warrior two. Last time into triangle. Back to your warrior two. And then we'll take it to that extended side angle. So front arm, front thigh. Press the thigh away, lift through that top shoulder. Lengthen through the back arm. And see if you can nestle down through the hips. We're going to take this to reverse warrior. So we're taking top hand, slide it down the back, lifting up through the front hand. And sweep it back. Steady breaths in and out. And again. Sweep it back, extended side angle. One more. Sweep it back. So pivot on that back foot. We're going to come back to our high lunge. We ground through the hands. And you take a vinyasa. So you sweep that leg back. Bring it to the floor. Keep it up. Exhale. Lower down. Inhale. Press your up dog or cobra. And then downward facing dog. Inhale, lengthen, look forward, drive the feet in between the hands, and again, lengthen, look forward. And exhale, fold. Inhale, wind, look. Exhale, lower. Coming back to chair on our right. Then going to let that foot slide so it comes to the front of your thigh, because we're going to come to figure four chair. So let that foot slide forward as you sit back into your chair. Steady in breath, out breath. We're going to lower this foot to the floor and carry on to the forward fold. So follow that foot, lower down. Inhale, lengthen, look forward. Exhale, step or jump. Carry on your exhale, lowering down to the floor. We're going to stay on the floor here though. So press to cobra. So think about rolling the ankle bones in. That should feel your bottom become nice and active. You don't have to lengthen through the hands fully if you're just being to the lower back. Or you could stay low. So take your option. If you want more, keep pressing through the feet and lift your up dog. Steady breaths. Last one, roll it to your downward facing dog. Keep breathing. Bit of a challenge for the arms now. So keep thinking about staying square to the mat. We're going to lengthen right hand, down back past buttock. Steady breaths. Sweep it back. Other side. Keep breathing. Place the hand. Inhale up onto tiptoes, drive the feet forward between the hands, lengthen, look forward. Exhale and fold. Sit back into your chair. And we're going to come to that figure four chair. So you've got to pick your left foot up this time. and come into that figure four. Woo, shouldn't have looked at the camera then. Lose my balance. Connect with that breath. And then we're going to come into tree. So grab that ankle, feed it up into your tree. And find that vision point. Reconnect with that breath. And on your next exhale, lower hands and feet. Moon salutation. Inhale, taking hands high. Exhale, half moon. Inhale up. Exhale, half moon, the other side. Inhale up. From here, we're going to pick up the right leg. We're going to stride and open out to goddess. You're going to turn, facing Nina, hopefully. Both feet turned out. And we're going to sink down to our goddess and inhale up to star. And again, exhale. Inhale up. Exhale. Inhale up. Exhale, come back to our goddess. And we're just going to hold here. So you can keep your arms out like so. You can bring them to your hands, to your thighs. And just see if you can encourage the knees a little wider. Feel free to have a little shimmy around. From here, we're gonna angle the feet directly towards me. And then lengthen through the legs. Wide leg forward fold. So ground then through the hands, whether that's onto your thighs, to the floor, think about setting those sit bones high. And then we're going to come to Skandasana. So this is where you sink through one knee, keep the other leg straight. You've got option to keep the foot ground, or you can open out and take the heel off on the back one. Your choice. So come back, wide leg forward fold, and then sink into that back leg. So we're just staying on the one leg, one side I should say. Press again. Once more, sink down, Skandasana. Keep breathing and press away. That should be a challenge into that back thigh. We're going to open up again into our goddess. So ground through the feet strongly to come up. Angle the heels in. And sink to goddess. And then we're going to step it into the front of the mat. The pivot on the back foot, stride it in. Inhale, lengthen hands up. Half moon to the side. Inhale up. Half moon. Inhale up. Other side now, so left leg. We're going to pick it up, stride it back. Open to that goddess. So inhale up to star, looking up, open through the chest. Exhale, sink into your goddess, knees bend wide. And again, inhale up. Exhale, sink. And again, inhale up. And exhale. Coming back up now, angle the toes forward and open to extended side angle. So think that long line through the spine and then grounding through the hands. Skandasana. So you're sinking into that back knee and either keeping the feet ground or opening out, depends what you want to do. But then you're going to press back up, wide leg forward fold. And again,
So the more you keep the feet ground, the stronger you're going to work into that back leg. Wide leg forward fold again. Once more. And wide leg forward fold. Ground through the feet, press yourself up. Angle the ankles, the heels in. And come back to your goddess. So either keeping the hands lifted or bringing them down onto the thighs. And then feel to have that little shimmy around here. Think about really sending the knees wide. You should strongly feel that into your bum. And then we're going to release to the front of the mat again. So stride it in. Sun salutation again. Inhale, lengthen up. Exhale, full fold. Inhale, lengthen, look forward. Exhale, step or jump. Carry on that exhale, lowering to the floor or hover up. Inhale, press to your up dog or cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. Right leg, lengthen up. Stride it forward in between the hands. Press, high lunge. Open warrior two. Take it to your triangle, lengthen through the front leg. Folding into the front leg, extended side angle. Keeping the front leg bent, reverse your warrior. Take it to a high lunge. Ground through the hands and take your vinyasa. So exhale to the floor. Inhale, up double cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. On the left, lengthen up. Inhale, stride it forward, high lunge. Open warrior two. Triangle, lengthen through the front leg. Extended side angle. Reverse your warrior. High lunge. And take your vinyasa. So we should be meeting back and downward facing dog. Inhale, stride it forward between the hands, lengthen, look forward. Exhale, full fold. Inhale, rise it up. And exhale, hands to heart center. So hopefully you've got that heart flowing. We'll just finish on the floor to get that heart rate back down. So coming to the floor however you choose, if you want a balance challenge, coming on to tiptoes, stay with hands in prayer, and lower down. And sitting back. See if you can come to boat pose with control. So you're going to sit, I have to send my knees away for that, and come to your boat. So you could have hands down on the floor of your boat or lifted, roll off that sit bone and lift to your boat with that short bent knees or lengthen. My hamstrings do not want to do that this morning. Connect with that breath. See if you can take hands high, more abdominal challenge,
and float them down. Two more. Inhale. And exhale. Last one. And then I'm going to come to the floor. So while you're using your hands or your control, keep rolling, rolling, rolling. Down to the floor. One leg down, then the other. Take hands up, palms up. Knee roll, one direction, then the other. And then option adding a lengthen through the top leg. You can take foot to hand if you want. The other side. Ooh, I'm gonna kick my fire. And back into center. Butterfly pose or cobblers, taking feet together. Soles of the feet come in, knees send out. If this doesn't feel nice in the lower back, then ignore me. Or you can try pillows under the knees to lessen the range, or a pillow under the bum, or hands if you don't want to get up. But basically, find a comfy position, whatever suits you. Palms come up, nestle the shoulders down away from the ears, and close those eyes off. And bring your awareness back to the breathing. Steady in-breath through the nose. Let the belly expand, the rib cage move as you breathe in. Now as you breathe out, let everything nestle back down. Focus on your breathing for your next three breaths. Gently encourage your knees into one another, and then drawing one knee towards your chest, then the other. A little roll or a rock. And then rolling onto your side. Yourself up. And we are done for today. I hope you enjoyed it. Leave me any questions, comments, and I will get back to you. And I'll see you all again soon. Thank you.